Hi there. So I wanted to give a little my opinion on this incident. So here's a picture of Don Cherry. I guess that's his wife Luba. I was just looking for a picture of him to show for the video. I don't know anything about her, but I assume that's her. But I want to go to my notes. I wrote down my notes about what happened, so I'm going to refer to that because it's on my phone. Now, last night, when I was prepared, had nothing else going, I listened to the podcast with Tim, his son. And it was over in a, I was surprised they talked about it, but I give Tim credit, some credit. He said, where is it? He said, I guess, Dad, we have to talk about it, unfortunately. So I don't want to speak for him. I don't know what he means by unfortunately. Does he mean I don't want to talk about it? Or does he mean that's what I think he means? But he could also mean it's a rough topic. That I think should have been clarified by Tim. If he doesn't clarify it, I'm going to assume he means we don't want to talk about it. And so I lost a lot of I lost a little respect for Tim. Don't know the guy, but he seems like a nice guy. I said in the previous video, I'm really questioning what he means by that, but I'll let it go. It's not the biggest deal. And then the other thing about Tim, I think like Don says he likes baseball. I'm not a big baseball guy, but I stopped playing baseball after T-ball. But like a baseball manager, Tim should have covered Don more in this. He kind of introduced the topic and then he left the room, in my opinion. Kind of left his dad out on his own. Maybe Tim wanted nothing to do with it. I don't know. But he kind of let his dad down in that. Introduced the topic and then left him on his own. And left his dad to hang himself, in my opinion, as I'll get to in a second. If I had to couch this, I would say this is the most trouble he's gotten himself into since he made the milk and honey comments. I put that down. Let me get into it. I wrote down his quotes, but I'm going to put a link in. I just found a link with just his comments on the Kyle Beach incident. It's only 3 minutes, so you can watch it yourself. Don said, I think it's my version, Don says. Now, really, what he means is I'm going to say the way I think what it means. And I think the really unfortunate words, and I'll tell you why that is in a minute. Don says, quote, nothing means nothing. Tim didn't step in again. I don't know, what does that mean? Nothing means nothing. I don't know what he means. I don't blame the kid. Well, I hope you don't. Good heavens. What kind of comment is that? I better calm down here. First he said, like he says, this is my version, as though he knows what went on. He doesn't know anything of what went on. He has no insight into this. And next thing you know, he's talking about when he went through the airport when he was going to play the Canadians. What does that have to do with it? Nothing. Tim didn't step in again. And he starts talking about this, and Tim interrupts and says, you're talking about when you went through immigration. This is what happened all the time when he was with Ron. Don would start talking. There's no context. People could easily assume it means something else. Ron would interject to try to clarify, and Don would get upset because he's interrupting him. I don't want to go off because this will be too long. I could go on for about an hour on this. I put down in my words, he's sounding demented like Biden or Ballard, Harold Ballard. To me, it's better to say nothing and be thought a fool than to open your mouth and prove you're a fool. That's a quote from a famous person, you know who. Don sounds, well, I don't know if this is true. I put down Don sounds narcissistic because he's making it about himself and not about Kyle Beach. So then I went into the comments of the Kyle Beach on YouTube, and I thought you often get some real insight when you get people commenting. They always have some good insight, and I wrote down because I wanted to quote them. Who said it? Michael Cassidy says, "You don't get it!" Exclamation mark. It's not about the cup. And I thought that was exactly right. Way to go, Michael Cassidy. Mike Koska says, upset. I just wrote down a few words. He says, Kyle's upset that nothing was done, Don. Don't you understand that? And then the best was by We Go Grey Cup. Don cannot string a sentence together. That's what I said. So I agree with you, We Go Grey Cup. And then he quotes him saying, "I'm never wrong." And then he adds, "or coherent." We Go Grey Cup. I think your comments were the best. Jim Boyko says, "Don, you are wrong. Full stop." And Dean Char says, "I think Dean put in some comments that I would have put in. I used to listen to." What was it called? Cherry. What do they call it? When Don used to speak in the intermission. Was it called Coach's Corner? Sorry, I drew a blank there. And he says, "I used to listen to Coach's Corner, and I'm very disappointed in Don." So those are five people who made comments in the video, and I thought they were all spot on. I don't want to bury the guy. I thought this shows how out of touch this guy is. Now, is it all about dementia? I don't know. I don't know if Don has dementia. I don't know if he has what he has, to be honest. But if he's going to keep continuing to comment, and then I think he has the right to be criticized for his comments. Just like I do if I say something wrong on my videos. I think Don showed a total lack of insensitivity when they put that we're going to talk about Kyle Beach and then they don't make it about Kyle Beach. Is it a rough topic? You betcha. What happened to this guy is really unfortunate. But if you're going to comment about it, then comment about it. So I better leave it there before I say something and I make this video too long. I think Don did a disservice to this gentleman, and I think he should not comment about things he doesn't know about. Yeah, I'll leave it there because this is such a bad topic. Really disappointed in Don is what I would say. To sum up, really disappointed.